Hi, I'm here today to talk about how to unlock the hidden potential in your SiFly eFoil. I'm John from eFoilWorld, and today we're going to show you our new lineup of performance parts for your SiFly eFoil. This line includes a new series of wings, a modified propeller, and some accessories which will transform your riding experience completely. So to go more into the details about our wings, I'm going to call Adam, our cameraman, but also our rider of eFoilWorld. Hey Adam.
Hey John. Good to see you. Thanks, man.
So it took some time, right?
Yeah. We did spend about the last 6-7 months.
I would say so.
Yeah, and that was testing everything that we could get onto the board from every major manufacturer, building adapters as we went, just searching for the most balanced, neutral, and fun performance improvement for SiFly for this specific platform. And yeah, what we ended up with is a quiver of wings that somehow at the same time is far more efficient. It's also way more fun to ride. Way more neutral, balanced, and all three of them are far more agile than any of the standard wings from SiFly.
You are able to get almost 30% of more efficiency.
Absolutely. So we can take a look at this video here, and you'll see the first video is a comparison of the 1180, which is the cruiser wing, the super efficient one, with the 1080, which is the all-arounder. It's right in the middle. The 1180, you'll see, you can ride this thing all day at 14, 15, 16 amps. I'm 73 kilos on a good day. That means I can ride this board for 2.5 hours.
But 15 to 16 amps?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah, that's insane. If you look on your remote while you're riding, it will show you in real time your amps, your current. If you look in your app after the fact, it will show you a efficiency, that's watt hours per kilometer. One measures it over distance, the other really measures it over time. In the end, most people aren't riding to get from point A to point B. How long you can be on the water on your battery and how much fun you're having, that's what matters. But it's not just a big fat cruiser wing that drives like a truck. You can see in the video, it's fun to turn, it's very smooth, it's quite stable, but it turns a lot easier than most of the stock wings that you'll find out there. So you compare it to the 1080, which was on the right side of the video, that's the all-rounder wing, and it's a really great combination of both super efficiency, as well as it's a lot more fun to turn than the 1180. It's more agile. It moves a lot quicker from edge to edge, as you can see. And even with the 1080, I'm able to ride at 17, 18 amps, or the equivalent would be 55, 56 watt hours per kilometer.
That's still enormous efficient.
Yeah, that lets me ride for 2 hours straight. Now, if we compare that to the high performance wing, the 870, that's the next step up. It's not going to be nearly as efficient as the first two, but it's closer to what you might experience from the aluminum dual wing or even the SiFly 1300. But it's doing that and with much better performance characteristics. This wing loves to carve really hard. It switches edges super fast. Edge to edge within a second, half a second is no problem. And it really, once you get used to it, to that feeling of slight roll instability, it becomes second nature. You don't have to think or push to turn. You just look where you want to go and the board lays on an edge and goes there. And it requires very little back foot pressure to just whip around the corners. And if we talk about speed, that's one of the benefits of both the 1180 and the 1080. The original aluminum wing, you will be using 25 amps if you're going 19 kilometers an hour or 25. Because at 19, it's doing a wheelie and it's pushing the water out of the way.
Correct.
And at 25, it's finally going fast enough to work efficiently. But then it's also using a lot of amps. With both the 1180 and the 1080, you can ride at 17, 18. The board is perfectly flat. And your amp draw is linear with your speed up to a point in that window of maximum efficiency. So it's really a super fun combination of wings that let you kind of pick and choose on the day. What performance do I want? Do I want to just have a nice slow day out on the water? Or do I want to just go rip it up and lean really hard in turns and come back with my legs tired?
So Adam, let's continue and let's speak about the ModiFlite. It's our modified propeller, right?
Yeah, so first off, there's nothing wrong with the SiFly propeller. It works great, it's extremely forgiving, and it's great to learn on. But if you've ever ridden a flight board, you know that the throttle responds a lot quicker. And that's because the propeller, for the same diameter, has about 30% more surface area. So it just moves a lot more water, and it gives you a very different riding experience. Unfortunately, you can't just put the flight prop on your SiFly. It won't fit. And it's not a simple solution to make it fit either. It's a little complicated. In the end, we built a couple of tools and figured out how to do it. And now it pops right on. And it really, really will change the way that your board feels when you're riding. In fact, almost every rider that we've tested with it immediately shifts down two gears, sometimes three, for the same speed that they're used to riding on the SiFly propeller.
Right.
What that means is much less lower RPMs, typically 7,000 instead of 10,000, much quieter, and just a much more connected tactile experience when you ride. The board responds a lot faster.
Besides the propeller, we made some changes to the tail cone.
Right. The flight propeller has a larger center hub than the SiFly. You created your own tail cone that pops right on there. Has a larger ending, and it closes the gap a little bit too. So you end up with a nice, smooth flow of water into the propeller. And again, that just increases the efficiency even more and makes for a smoother riding experience.
And then we come to the end of the fuselage, and there's the back wing. We tested all with the standard SP240 from SiFly, which is a great wing.
Absolutely.
But in case of a budget, we also modified this one. This is the eFW-235.
Right. Yeah, it's an ABS version of the SP240. So first off, I highly recommend the SP240 with any of these wings. That's what they're all designed to work with. That's what they were tested with. And that's what creates the most neutral riding platform that also loves to turn and is nice and stable in centered flight. The ABS version that SiFly makes is very similar. It works fantastic. But we noticed on some setups it was whistling, which doesn't really impact your performance much, but it's annoying. Your board to be quiet. You want to hear the water behind you. And simply by changing the tips just a little bit, we managed to get rid of that whistling. And the only difference you're going to notice really between the not cheap SP240 and the ABS version from you, which is based off of the SiFly one, is if you really load the board into turns, you can feel the ABS wing give a little bit and then pop back, whereas the carbon one won't do that. The carbon one stays nice and linear the whole way through.
So for everybody that wants to test one of our wings, just contact us. It's really recommended to do so. You will like it. Adam, I thank you. Thank you for all your time and all the whole result we have brought to the market. And have a good trip back home.
Yeah. Hey, it's been a pleasure, man. Thanks.